चाल आहे. भाई बोलियो बा.
Kinematics of Particles Part 1. But before we start, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Tinikat ang Musikero, and press our notification bell. So, open your YouTube channel. You will be given some updates about our channel. Now, let us start with our session, our discussion about Dynamics of Rigid Bodies, Kinematics of Particles, Part 1. Start with, we have our Kinematics of Particles, Chapter 1. And here are some of our objectives with our discussion. At the end of the lesson, the students should be able to differentiate the branches of dynamics, know the basic concepts underlying kinematics of particles, solve worded problems. And to start with, let us have now the definition of dynamics. Dynamics is the branch of mechanics which deals with the study of bodies in motion. And we also have the branches of dynamics. Number one, we have the kinematics. Kinematics is the geometry in motion. Term is used to define the motion of a particle or body without consideration of the forces causing the motion. Second one, we have the kinetics. And here is our definition for kinetics. Kinetics is the branch of mechanics that relates the force acting on a body to its mass and
pag-i-mute yung mga phone ninyo, class. Okay, so that walang ma-interrupt para hindi naririnig yung ibang noise. Makinig kayong mabuti sa discussion natin sa video, no?
And acceleration. Followed by the symbols and notation. S stands for distance, X horizontal displacement, Y vertical displacement, V velocity, V sub F final velocity, V sub 1 initial velocity, A stands for acceleration, G acceleration due to gravity, T.
So may value ang G, no? Acceleration due to gravity is equal to 9.81 meter per second square, while in English system, 32.2 feet per second square. So, dalawa yan, no, yung value niya. Sa English and metric also.
Stands for time. Kinematics of particles. And this is our outline regarding about the kinematics of particles. First, we have the rectilinear motion. So let us put letter C with our word rectilinear. So this must be rectilinear. Followed by special case of relative motion. Graphical solutions, curvilinear motions of particles, then rectangular components.
So yun yung mga outline na ating tatalakayin sa kinematics of particles, no? Medyo ibabalik ko lang ng konti. Ito yung mga tatalakayin natin. We have rectilinear motion,
then
special case of relative motion, graphical solutions, curvilinear, and non-rectangular components. So, makababa yan.
Rectangular components. And for our short introduction, allow me to define again kinematics. Kinematics means study of the geometry of motion. Relates displacement, velocity, acceleration and time without reference to cause motion. Kinematic relationships are used to help us determine the trajectory of a projectile, speed of satellite in its orbit, and accelerations of various particles. Let's talk about now particles. Particles moving or move by vibrating, but do not change positions. When solids get hot, the particles vibrate more. Increased vibration pushes the particles farther apart, causing the solid to expand. We are surrounded by solids, liquids, and gases. Particle is a term used to denote an object's point size. A system of particles which form into appreciable size is termed as body. These terms may apply equally to the same object. The Earth, for example, may be assumed as a particle in comparison with its orbit. Whereas to observe on the Earth, it is a body with appreciable size. In general, a particle is an object whose size is so small in comparison with its path.
So I need to skip this. I think this is a commercial, huh? Stand by. Okay, continue.
Particles. Not strictly the small particles, possibly as large as cars, rockets, or airplanes. The entire bodies will analyze, any rotation to the center will be neglected. Kinematics, particle cases. Cylinder motion, position, velocity, and acceleration of particles that moves along a straight line. Curvilinear motion, position, velocity, and acceleration of particles as it moves along a curved line in two or three dimensions. Curvilinear motion of particles. Again, curvilinear translation, motion along a straight line. Second one, motion with constant velocity, uniform motion, wherein S is equal to V times T, or distance is equal to the product of velocity and time. Motion with constant acceleration. Sometimes we call it as horizontal motion. Under this horizontal motion, we actually have the three kinematic equations.
Okay, pause muna ako. No? Since ako yung naging teacher niyo sa physics, sino bang nakakaalala sa inyo ng dalawa pang kinematic equation na meron tayo maliban dyan? Di ba tatlo yan? Ano yung second kinematic equation, if you can still recall? Kailangan kasi kabisado niyo yung mga formula na yan eh. Okay, anyone among you, ano yung formula ng displacement? I think displacement, yun yung kinematic equation number 2 natin. And then, final velocity na nakascore din yung ating third kinematic equation under ng horizontal motion. Okay, what do you think are those two, if you can still recall? Pakirecall nga. Tingnan ko nga kung naalala pa ninyo. Ano yung pangalawa? Sige, again up.
V of x squared is equals to V of I squared plus 2as.
That was the third kinematic equation. I-score natin
ang final. Yung natatandaan ko, sir.
Yes, anak. Tama, tama. So, yung final velocity na naka-square is equal to the initial velocity and then square. Plus or minus, pipili tayo sa dalawang sign, kung plus ba or minus. dito ginamit is positive, so nag-assume kagad na acceleration. No? Why plus or minus? Because possibly there is the acceleration or acceleration. And then 2ax in yung last term. So let's play now yung ating video.
We have to remember vf or final velocity is equal to the sum of initial velocity plus the product of acceleration and time. Again, v sub f is equal to v sub I plus at, or final velocity is equal to initial velocity plus acceleration times time. For second kinematic equation, s or distance s is equal to v sub 1 or v sub it plus 1 up at square. The third one, third kinematic equation, vf square is equal to v sub I square plus 2as. Again, under rectilinear motion of particles, we also have the free falling body. Sometimes we call it as the vertical motion. We also have three kinematic equations under free falling body. First one, velocity is equal to g times t. H is equal to 1 up gt squared. V squared is equal to 2gh. Or, again, our three kinematic equations. We can also use this set of formulas. Vfy is equal to Viy plus or minus Gt. Y is equal to V sub Iy times the time plus or minus 1 half Gt squared. Or, our third kinematic equation. V sub Fy square is equal to V sub Iy square plus 2gy as our third kinematic equation. Motion with variable acceleration. Acceleration is equal to the derivative of velocity with respect to time, or dv over dt. V is equal to ds over dt, or the derivative of distance with respect to time. Vdv is equal to ads, velocity, times derivative of velocity is equal to acceleration, times the derivative of distance. Again, s stands for distance, h as height, v velocity, v sub f as our final velocity, V sub I, initial velocity. A stands for acceleration. G, acceleration due to gravity. Value of G, 9.81 meter per second square in SI units. And G is equals to 32.2 feet per second square in English system. Finally, we have time, or T stands for time. Important notes that we have to remember. B is positive, B is increasing, meaning there is an acceleration. A is negative, if velocity is decreasing, meaning there is a deceleration. G is positive, if the particle is moving downward. The value of G is negative, if the particle is moving upward.
So, importante yung mga concept na yan, yung mga notes na yan. Ano? Especially yung dalawang nasa baba, yung G is positive. If the particle is moving downward, so walang letter I ito, no? Paki-correct na lang spelling. G is negative if the particle is moving upward. So, sa free fall body, kapag nag-compute tayo ng motion problems, huwag natin kakalimutan na kapag paakyat ang object, or we have thrown an object vertically upward, the sign that we're going to use, because the movement is upward, is negative. Negative ang value ng g natin. Pero kapag pababa ang object, we will use the positive kasi sumusunod naman talaga yan sa direction ng gravity. Kaya positive ang ating gagamitin. medyo i-oppose natin yung principle sa Cartesian coordinate system, di ba, no? Sa Cartesian coordinate system, kapag pataas, positive. Kapag bababa, negative. Now, with the concept of free fall body, tandaan natin yung dalawang important notes na yan, na G is positive if the particle is moving downward, and G is negative if the particle is moving upward. So, typographical error. This must be particle, hindi particle, no? L-E yan. Paki-correct na lang. Okay, continue.
Peaceful conversion factors. From kilometer per hour, we need to convert it into meter per second. We need to multiply it by 1 over 3.6 meter per second.
So, yan yung mga shortcuts, no? Binahagi ko na kasi alam ko kailangan nyo yan. I-senior ko na rin sa video natin. Mga shortcut ng mga conversion. Hindi yung alamin mo muna kung ilang metro sa isang kilometro, ilang metro sa isang kilometro, ilang segundo sa isang oras. Diyan ang haba ng calculation mo. I-multiply mo lang ng 1 over 3.6. Pareho lang ang sagot. Okay, continue.
And to convert it into kilometer per hour, we need to multiply it by 3.6. Miles per hour to feet per second, we need to multiply by 22 over 15. Feet per second, to convert it into miles per hour, we need to multiply it by 15 divided by 22. Now, here are some of our summary of kinematic relations regarding about rectilinear motion. The first one, differentiate position to get velocity and acceleration. We need the following formulas. Velocity is equal to the derivative of distance with respect to time. Acceleration is equal to dv over dt. A is equal to v times the second derivative of distance with respect to time. Acceleration is equal to v dv over dx. Second one, integrate acceleration for velocity and position. Velocity. Velocity is equal to the integral of dB limits initial velocity to final velocity, also equal to the integral of time or dt limits 0 to time, or BdB integral having a limits of initial velocity to final velocity, and the integral of ds s above 2 s as its limits. Let's talk about the position. Integral of ds starting from lower limit to upper limit s above 2 s also equal to the integral of ds from lower limit of 0 to upper limit of t, or also equal to v dt integral 0 to time or t. Note that s above and v above represent the initial position and velocity of the particle at time is equal to 0. God is truly great. God is good and generous. Thank you very much. A beautiful light to each and every one of us. Discussion in this session is all about dynamic of rigid bodies, kinematics of particles, part 2. By the way, make sure matinig ka sa Musikero channel while signing on. Before we start the discussion, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Tinig ka sa Musikero. Press the notification bell so that you will be given more updates every time you're going to open your YouTube account. Let's start our discussion. Start with So by example number one, given an equation of motion, x is equal to 6t squared minus t cubed. To solve it, we have the following questions. What are x, b, and acceleration?
Okay, I am requiring you to be more attentive with this. You study every detail while you are watching, and then try to think of some questions that you may raise right after these videos. X is equal to 6t squared minus t cubed. Marunong naman kayo ng differential calculus. Alam naman ninyo ang inyong integral calculus. So I think makaka-catch up kayo dito. Marunong kayo ng Cartesian coordinate system. So pakinggan nyo lang maigi at panoorin ang proseso kung paano tayo mag-calculate. Ako din naman yung nagsasalita dyan na madali pa rin yan. Kayang-kaya ninyo yan.
Time of 2 seconds. The second question. What are x, displacement, b, velocity, and acceleration at time of 2 seconds? In order to calculate, and in order to have our graph, to solve for some coordinates, to start with, let us try using the time of 0 seconds. Time 0 second. Let's use the equation of our motion. X is equal to 6t squared minus t cubed. Substitution. X is equal to 6 times 0 squared minus 0 cubed. Is equal to 0. Now we have our ordinate as 0. An abscissa of 0. Our first coordinate now is 0 and 0. Let's move to our second coordinate. Using the time of 2 seconds, since our question goes like this, what are x, b, and acceleration of time of 2 seconds? So let us use 2 seconds. Our time of 2 seconds, using the equation of motion, a substitution for x is equal to 6 times 2 squared minus 2 cubed. 16 meters. And we have our second coordinate as 16. Now let us have a try for 4 seconds. Time of 4 seconds is substitution. X is equal to 6 times the square of 4 minus the cube of 4. And we have 32 meters as our coordinate. Now we have another coordinate. Let us have another try by using the time of 6 seconds. Again, by substitution to the equation x is equal to 6t squared minus t cubed. We have our equation now as x is equal to 6 times the square of 6 minus the cube of 6. We have a value of 0. Now let us have our sketchable graph. Let us have our figure. For our first coordinate, we have 0 and 0 by using the time of 0 seconds and having an ordinate of 0. For our second coordinate, by using the time of 2 seconds and having a result of 16 meters, we have now our coordinate as 16. For the third one, by using the time of 4 seconds, we have calculated for the value of x as 13 meters so that we can have the coordinates of 4 and 32. And for our last coordinate, by using the time of 6 seconds, we have calculated for the value of x.
You have to remember these two coordinates, no, mga anak, no? The 2 and 16 and 4 and 32. 16 meters kapag 2 seconds. 32 naman kapag ang time is 4 seconds. Kasi yun yung mga questions sa taas, oh, nasasagot na natin. Okay, let's proceed.
X, which is equal to 0, it is also our ordinate. Now we have the coordinates as 0 and 0. And for the continuation of our solution, let us have now the derivative of our x equation with respect to time so that we can calculate for the value of our velocity. Velocity now is equal to the derivative of x with respect to time. It is also equal to 12t minus 3t squared. Because the derivative of 6t squared is 12t, and the derivative of t cubed is 3t squared. By using this equation in our next slide, again we have v is equal to dx over dt equals 12t minus 3t squared. Again, let us have more coordinates for our new sketch of the graph by using the equation v is equal to 12t minus 3t squared. Using the time of 0 seconds, the solve for the velocity. Velocity now is equal to 12 times 0 minus 3 times the square of 0, which is equal to 0. So we already have our first coordinate as 0 and 0. Let's have another coordinate by using the time of 2 seconds. V is equal to 12 times 2 minus 3 times the square of 2. We have a value of 12 meters per second. So that we can have another coordinate as and 12. Let us have another try by using the time of 4 seconds. Let's calculate for the value of our velocity as our coordinate. V is equal to 12 times 4 minus 3 times the square of 4. We have a value of 0 as velocity. Report 1. Let's try a time of 6 seconds. What is then the velocity value? V is equal to 12 times 6 minus 3 times the square of 6. We have a negative 6 value. Our velocity. And we have already completed all the coordinates that we need so that we can sketch the graph of our equation of motion. V is equal to 12t minus 3t squared. So as you can see, we already have our graph. Let's start first with our first coordinate. By using the time of 0 second, we have the coordinates as 0 and 0. A second coordinate, we have used the time of 2 seconds so that we can have a velocity of 12 meters per second. I think this is the maximum velocity that we can have. Coordinates, we have 2 and 12. Our third coordinate, by using the time of 4 seconds, calculate the velocity of 0. Its coordinates are 4 and 0. Our fourth coordinate, time of 6 seconds, using velocity is equal to 12 minus 3 squared by substitution. We have calculated value of negative 36. Now we have the coordinates of our equation. X and negative 36. That's our x, velocity and acceleration at time of 2 seconds now. Time of 2 seconds, obviously, x is equal to 16 meters. Our previous slide.
So yun yung 16 meters, no, na pinarecall ko sa inyo kanina.
We can see in our graph. Meaning, velocity 12 meters per second is our maximum velocity. Believe the acceleration here is equal to 0. Note that maximum velocity occurs when acceleration is 0 and that the slope of the velocity of 0 is 5. For our next slide. For the continuation of our computation, let's proceed now to the acceleration. Acceleration is equal to the derivative of velocity with respect to time, or its second derivative with respect to x, with respect to time. For the second derivative of x with respect to time is equal to 12 minus 16. Now, let us solve for sets of coordinates again. By using the time 0 second, solve for the value of our acceleration. It's acceleration is equal to 12 minus 6 times 0. And we have a result of 12 meters per second squared. Let's have another try. Time of seconds. The substitution will be given equation B is equal to 12 minus 16. E now is equal to 12 minus 6 times 2. We have an acceleration of 0. Time of 4 seconds. Acceleration is equal to 12 minus 6 times 4. So that we can have a value of negative 12 meters per second squared. Meaning there is an acceleration. For the fourth one, time of 6 seconds. Acceleration is equal to 12 minus 6 times 6. We have a negative 24 meters per second squared value. Now we have already completed all the coordinates that we need so that we can sketch the graph by equation of motion. Times of acceleration. Time. Let's have now sketch of the graph. Start with our first coordinate. By using the time of 0 second, we have calculated an acceleration of 12 meters per second squared. That's why we have our coordinate as 0 and 12. See to the next coordinate. Time of 3 seconds, we have calculated an acceleration value of 0. That's why our coordinates are 2 and 0. The third one, using the time of 4 seconds, we have calculated for the value of our acceleration as negative 12. So why we have our coordinates as 4 and negative 12? For our fourth coordinate, time of 6 seconds is equal to negative 24. So our coordinates then are 4 and negative 24. What are x, displacement or distance, and v or velocity, acceleration at time? B seconds. I think this should be 4 seconds. For this, the variable B to a number 4. Let's correct it. So this must be 4. And the continuation. Time of 4 seconds, x maximum is equal to 32 meters. So you can see this from our previous slide. X maximum or distance is 32 meters, and then the velocity is equal to 0. Acceleration is negative 12 meters per second squared. God is really great. God is good and generous. Thank you very much and thank you for watching. Buhay ang bawat kabataan Pilipino.